The presentation is on scaling up locally led adaptation through local adaptation plan of action.
Local adaptation plan of action called LAPA is a mechanism or approach through which different stakeholders, whether they are central, provincial or local government, they act in a collective manner with the aim that it trickle downs climate financing at the local level, builds capacity of the local government to really integrate climate change adaptation in their planning and budgeting process, and mobilizes the vulnerable group, especially youth, women, children, so that they are part of the decision-making, planning and implementation that are aimed at reducing risks and building the adaptive capacity and overall building resilience of their society.
In Nepal, that has been in practice since 2010. And particularly LAPA, that is a very popular program in Nepal on climate change adaptation at local level, that has been localized and decentralized by the government. It uses particularly tools of BRA in which districts and communities are differentiated based on their vulnerability. It is actually community-led and multi-stakeholder initiative. And it integrates the financial mechanism from different sources, government, donor, local government, and it can have budget from donor, though both on budget and off budget, both kind of budget. So it particularly focuses on reducing risk and vulnerability of the poor people. And actually it integrates gender and social inclusion component of climate change. So it includes women, youth, children, and other. Particularly it integrates traditional knowledge and current science. You know that when we prepare NAP, National Adaptation Plan, now question is how to implement the NAP at local level. LAPA is a means to implement national level of adaptation at local level. So particularly in the NAP, LAPA framework, in which institution, policy, strategy, all level of government are integrated into one. So this is the model how the LAPA is being implemented at local level. So particularly, it has been truly decentralized, truly localized. So it integrates with local community group, particularly community forestry, irrigation, and other groups. So particularly LAPA is not business, it is business unusual, because decisions are made at local level, lowest level, in which groups are formed and user committees are formed, in which particularly women, youth, children are given priorities. And the funds that is available from donor communities are prioritized. It has been said that 80% of budget should go to local communities to implement the LAPA. So it invests in local people in order to develop their capacity and capability so that they can continue their intervention and the program may be sustainable. So the LAPA reduces climate risk and uncertainty. It is flexible in terms of programming and learning. Particularly, it is based on community choice, community's priority, particularly, and it ensures transparency and accountability, because people, when the funds are allocated at local level, so there is inbuilt process, having monitoring and evaluation and public auditing very clearly. So through LAPA process, there is an opportunity for collaborative action and investment through government, through donor, through community, through NGO, through civil society organization. So there is an opportunity. So if we talk about journey of LAPA, so I already spelled that. It has been started since 2010. Then first support that we have received from DFID and EUA, particularly to implement the LAPA process. The government then put the provision that 80% of the budget should go to the local communities in order to implement LAPA. Now the government intend to implement LAPA in all 753 local governments. So in government, particularly intend to produce report in every 5 years, particularly with regards to how the program is implemented. Now Nepal, the political system in Nepal has been changed previously from a unitary system to federal system. So government also devised the LAPA framework in order to accommodate with federal system. So that is LAPA framework was revised in 2019. So there has been interconnection, vision, and financial flow. So particularly, it capacitated local community in terms of reducing immediate and urgent priority and reduce loss and damage of local communities. So the question, how international community can better support LAPA? So they can allocate support, particularly focusing on locally led adaptation that must be incremental, predictable, and timely. So the climate finance should be accessed directly. So the intermediary organization should not be expensive. The support that has been received in Nepal should go to local community. So we know that LDCF, Adaptation Fund, and different funding window, they need to focus funding on locally led adaptation. Now at the moment, the amount of funding is just more than 30%. So we can develop a mechanism of tracking, measuring, and reporting, particularly on money being allocated to adaptation based on the framework that is being implemented. Particularly, there has been limitation. If the budget is allocated by national government, that don't reach its local level in time. It is a matter, not matter of corruption, but it is a matter of delay and bureaucracy. So particularly our request to international communities provide adequate funding support for implementation, both in terms of hardware and software.
The LAPA begins with mobilizing the local communities, especially these vulnerable and the most marginalized group. So they are involved in, you know, looking at what are the issues of climate change, how climate change is impacting them, their livelihood, their other resources, and why it is a problem for them. Then they will look at probable you know, causes of climate change across different tiers of livelihood assets, where it is impacted. They'll look at how specific you know, interest group are impacted negatively. And then they are the one who are also proposing that what should be done. So if you look into whole, you know, assessing, designing and planning in all stages, these groups, especially women, children, disabled, elderly, and especially ethnic communities are part of this whole process and cycle of really, you know, building on the local knowledge and try to identify their issues as well as suggest what could be best for them and for the communities.
LAPA is a process. It is a framework. It is a document. It is a implementation mechanism of locally led adaptation, particularly governed by local communities based on political boundary or local government. In their constitution, it has been said that 1/3 of the representative must be from women, girls, disabled. And that means at least 1/3 represented must be from gender and social inclusion. That has been legally binding. So they intend to raise this threshold to 50%.
So one of the major lessons was during the piloting and implementation phase, it was, you know, LAPA was more projectized. So it looked like a parallel process through which, you know, development agencies funded projects are running in parallel with local government planning. But after the federalism, since local government already have the institution structure mandate, you know, separate legal policy, and they are capable of doing that. So in the spirit of the federalism, the LAPA framework really focused on, now we can't do, you know, parallel planning. So LAPA has to be part of the local planning and budgeting process, where local government will take lead, where local communities will be involved in identifying their needs and priorities, where the resources will be, you know, decentralized and you know, flow through the local government to the targeted groups. So this is one fundamental thing is, how do you really move from projects to more program and more mainstreaming approach? Second fundamental thing is, because there has been so much investment on development, so one of the challenges is how to make development investment more secure and how to make development more climate resilient. So the LAPA focus is not just only on community-based, you know, community-led livelihood. It also looked into infrastructure or resources that are used by community, that are you know, for the communities. So how can local government secure their investment through climate resilient development planning and budgeting process? So the climate resilient, you know, planning and budgeting really guides the local governments to really look into the development project so that they can, you know, climate proof their development investment as well as it will be sustainable. So these are the two basic principles which really recognizes local government at the heart, but it recognizes that it is for the local communities, it is for their, you know, enhancing their livelihood and resilience, and looking at the local infrastructure that are very, very important and relevant for sustaining the local livelihood. That's why it is locally led, means local governments are in the forefront, but in the decision making, but the benefit are all, you know, trickle down to communities and household level.